On March 24th, 1945, 3,000 airplanes assembled in the skies over Europe. Nearly 2,000 of the craft were B-17 and B-24 bombers. The rest were P-47 and P-51 fighters. In support of Operation Varsity, the 8th Air Force Strategic Bombing Campaign targeted airfields in West and Northwest Germany. And on that day, Allied planes stretched across the horizon, and their silhouettes blanketed the ground. The armada was so large that it was impossible to see it in its entirety from a single vantage point. The size and scope of this single campaign meant that one person could never see a complete image of the formation.
This is the B-17G model. What we're talking about is an Art Deco beautifully designed aircraft. And it's significant in the fact that it's what an airplane should look like. When we talk about the aesthetics of an airplane, big wings, deco design, what this plane signifies is a high level of human achievement and should be awe-inspiring from that capacity. If you think one of these is significant, think about 2,000 of them in formation. Now that's a hell of an aesthetic.
In an effort to create a sense of that spectacle, to represent that moment, artist Mark Thorkelson traveled to the United States Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. There he worked with 50 cadets on an interactive art installation.
That's about 3,000 airplanes in the airspace. That's pretty intense when you think about that. I thought about it. So what I did is I did a little history project, and I contacted one of the biggest Air Force generals, General Earl Partridge. He was the head of the 3rd Air Division in World War II, and he was in charge of getting this whole thing orchestrated. I asked him, I said, you know, well, I did a little interview with him. I said, point blank, how did they pull that off? You know, that seems like a big task to me. I was just trying to figure out how to get one plane in the pattern. The upshot of the conversation was this. So it took a high degree of cognizance on the part of the air crew to kind of figure it out as they went along, the freedom to make those decisions. And I thought that was interesting because I was looking for a very technical, specific answer about flight levels and plans like that. But the real key here was the cognizance on the individual air crew.
Using the idea of personal cognizance, Thorkelson encouraged the cadets to use their own creativity in rendering the formations of Operation Varsity. Silhouettes were laid out on two 40 by 100 foot plastic tarps. The cadets then hand stenciled 3,000 individual images, each one representing a plane in the air on that day.
Well, you guys have a little bit of scope and clue about what 3,000 airplanes look like now, but do you have any idea about what it'd be like getting them in formation in a relatively small airspace? Think about that, that's real drama. You know, it occurred to me about 10 years ago, I was at your little airfield down here near the freeway, trying to get one airplane in the patch. So they still have that Eagle guy, you talked to him at one point. He's keeping track of the airplanes, isn't he? He's getting me out on the right corridor to the practice area. So I take his job and multiply that by about 1,000. But I think the real high stakes drama is when you look at the actual flying. All right, this might be the view of an enemy fighter flying through a formation from a head-on attack. All right, can we free up about 6 people to do another thing underneath here? I'll tell you what this is going to signify. If we get 2 flight levels here, this is how the fighters would actually, at a greater ground speed, actually give fighter protection.
And each one flying by, so that these could fly over these, and these could fly under these, so that we could do that sort of thing.
I'm not talking about any moral judgment about wars or trying to glorify war in any sense like that. I don't know anything about war because I've never experienced it. I know a little bit about aviation and aviation history, and I'll tell you this. If you want beauty, go to a decorator. What we're trying to create here is art and a good aesthetic.
Previous artistic approaches to aviation have dramatized aerial combat. Thorkelson takes a different approach. This work instead speaks to the awe-inspiring achievement of flight and expresses that from a purely aesthetic standpoint. Thorkelson's work captures the energy, motion, and human aspect of flying, elevating the human spirit and creating a stronger, more positive connection between the viewer and the skies above.